Hello and welcome here. This is Hypertron, and today there is another battle in Epirus campaign, which we are hosting in multiplayer head-to-head campaign, and it's actually a difference. I mean, a bit of change here, because we are playing Epirus versus Seleucidae, which is, in my opinion, much more interesting campaign than Epirus in Syracuse, because it's of course very short term for, like, you know, warm up or something, which you can do some battles and quick stuff in early gaming. And today battle is another battle for Beneventium, but this time we are holding Epirus of Epirus in the city of Romans, which is pretty cool in my opinion, because you know, the city itself have very narrow streets, which actually can help you out to, you know, choke point the attackers, the invaders, and kill them as many as you can. I'm playing as Epirus, and Epirus himself here, which is of course in Royal Guard Cavalry. We have three units of Greek Bronze Shield Pikemen, and I believe 6 units of the Sporian infantry, which is pretty elite early gaming infantry for Epirus, and it's a pretty nasty unit to play against, because they are very good, have melee attack, they have very good weapon damage, and even pretty decent charge bonus for the infantry unit. Unfortunately, the armor is pretty low, which is you know, indicator for a longer melee fight, which can cause big casualties in the units, because of course if they get exhausted they die quickly, and because of lack of armor they are vulnerable to projectiles and even much more heavier infantry, which is Rome best part, of course, as you know, the Romans infantry, they all have good amount of armor. 38 on this triarii, of course. Princeps, they have 35, so it's very, very big amount of armor on the Roman infantry. Of course, the player I'm playing against is a good friend of mine, and we have some rules of engagement, which he have, of course, army marching here, and he'll try to, of course, outflank me here, and maybe some push to these corners. Of course, I'm trying to prevent him to take any kind of more city streets inside, because that will be trap me in this small corner, which I'll just be shoot at and kill down, which is actually not a bad idea, but of course it's killing immersion, and because you can blob up units inside the city, and you know, you have like one corridor here, one corridor here, and having fun. That's not the sieges I like to have. I'm putting some units here to, you know, prevent any kind of encirclement here and here, because I'm sending one unit of spears to help on this flank, because I actually put all my cav and elephants on the left, which elephants for the, of course, Epirus are Indian mercenary elephants. They are not pretty good counterparting to other units of elephants in the game. They're actually one of the weakest Indian mercenary elephants because of their low armor, which is only 6. The normal amount of armor in elephant units is 12. This is like a passive thing for them, so it's actually, I think it's for balance purposes, because if this unit would be much stronger, the Romans would have much more difficulty to deal with them. And because, of course, AI are not fighting in this kind of battles, you know, manual battles, they have statistics and automatic battles. Now, this statistic for elephants could change game a bit, so Epirus have much more, you know, opportunity to kill the enemy here in the battle, in the, you know, you single-player campaign, which you're not playing as Epirus, but something else, and they're fighting Rome, which is struggling. Here, of course, we can see more and more Camelian cavalry, which Rome have like multiple units. I don't actually know how many. I think 4, something like that. You have like 2 of them more. There's of course guard. There's some companion cavalry with javelins. another general, so it's like six, seven even. You have like seven unit here, another general bodyguard, a few triarii. I think you can see triarii. Of course, there are some Camelan veteran. This triarii have some, early hoplites. Those kind of guys are allied triarii. They are not like Triaria themselves. I think they are Triscans or something. In the army of Rome, of course, they're using some Italic people in the formations. And yeah, of course, the Romans are marching in their standard plus formation, which is no formation for my friend, of course. He just, trying to not harass his men in the moving, fast moving zone. So they'll be not tired after, going a bit in front. We have first a little engagement with my traps, or even no, we don't have. I put it like all traps here, so if he'll try to push cavalry, he'll have like high casualties because this is like spikes and those and other kind of spikes which I don't know how to spell them. And buried spike traps in the buried one, and of course few of my units that are in reserve facing of course the street, they have back their back are the city's buildings, so they cannot be surrounded easily, so the enemy have to like punch through here so I can put some infantry and sandwich them. Of course it's very risky because he can actually just open and block me here and slaughter this unit. But it's this strategy is to split up his forces as much as I can. That's why I'm using multiple streets lines to prevent his blobbing, because he's actually having more heavy infantry, which will cause, of course, a big, buff for his army. If, for example, majority of our armies would battling here, he could easily push through these units. Those are medium spear infantry units. Of course, I have some phalanx in reserve, but they are in the late game stage, because majority of missiles, majority of ammunition that he's going to spend on these kind of units that are pretty cheap. They are reasonable to recruit again. They are not costing big amount of manpower, the better class of manpower, so they can be thrown at first line in the battle. Some cavalry moving. I've decided to move my calf here in the center in case of going here, trying to do something here with my calf, but I just acknowledge myself. If you're going to send like more infantry from this direction, for example, to punch here or here from the streets, my cavalry is it very big disadvantage, because not only he have more calf, but his calf is also much faster than mine. I mean, majority of them are seven. Yeah, that's true, but they can easily catch my units which have eight. Basically just charge them, one little of my mistakes, and this unit will die. I also have few units of javelins. Agrianian peltasts are very good unit. They can throw the javelins, they have decent amount of melee attack and defense. Of course, they are lacking armor, but they are very good unit to take a melee AP damage. So it's pretty decent unit to throw against heavy armored units like Roman have. More and more Thesprotian infantry, and yeah, they are deployed in the different corners of the city. Two units here, two units here, and two units in the reserve in case of sending some reinforcements to these streets, so the enemy will not go through. Because if he'll get through here, this whole line have to retreat. And again, the best option here is to just move into inner zone and put a last stand in here, which I decided to move a bit, because I like basically I saw how much numbers the enemy have. Because I actually didn't see whole army. I just clicked play battle, and my friend did also. So I didn't count enemy units. And when I started counting, I was like, well, I'm not able to hold them here especially with these few units that are pretty light and they'll not able to hold longer. This checkpoint is very crucial for me because, you know, from this position they actually can enter much further development city and, you know, surround my units and slaughter them easily. So this point is the most important point in the battle. If they cross it, I'm dead basically. Of course, same from this section. That's why I love this city, because it's very, very nice to defend it. Of course, it's not having a walls, which is shame. Of course, walls would help a lot here. But look, you can actually, if I had more troops, because it's just one army, you know, with the like the littlest the garrison, because I just basically take the city from the room. I could like place again here some traps and some troops, you know, to prevent them from taking this position. I could send like one or two units here, so you have hard time to envelop. Of course, few units in reserve here, in the case there are some kind of, you know, points are going to collapse. And for most important here, you have like long battle line, which is bad and good in both options, because long battle line in defense, it will be like exhausting your men. Like, you know, you have to deploy here few units, like 4 or 3 units. You have to deploy here to defend this street properly. I know you actually can, you know, like take this kind of envelop and, you know, build your defenses and, you know, put your soldiers here. But again, it's not worth it, because if you're going put here, they actually can, you know, move their missile troops and shoot your infantry from the back, which is not very good idea. Better just, you know, move in that position. That will also extend enemy forces, because if I'm going to put, you know, many units of mine, the enemy have to put like the same amount of units to punch through. And if he don't, I can easily just, you know, move, sally out. If he's going to be enveloped here, I can sally out again, take his forces in open field. If he's going to, you know, deploy more infantry in the, you know, different part of the city, it's very helpful. He's going to throw his pillar here, I guess. This is not the battle right now, which is very important. He's just going to deploy, destroy the barricade, some, you know, deployments, like this, some traps. He's going to destroy them, defuse them, so his units can easily get through. And because those units actually have two volleys of javelins, they are very decent to have in the army. But when you have the ability to recruit the Agrinian axemen, they are much better against Roman, because of the, you know, penetration of armor in these units. It's extremely good against Rome in the early stage, because they don't have actually good counter for that. Of course, Rome have majority of units. So yeah, we have some units, we have some first engagement. My javelins are trying to shoot them down. Many javelins thrown in this unit. You can actually see this is brutal fighting started. Yeah, and he's going to return the volley. Not yet. Yeah, something like that. He's going to return the volley. And of course, like I said, that's why I love to put like light infantry units that are very cheap in front, because he's actually going to use his ammunition on them. And because of that, my better units will not suffer from this. And actually, pillar, javelins or anything that infantry can throw on the first stage is very deadly. Maybe not in kills sometimes. Of course, it's not like that these units get like good amount of kills. They didn't, but they actually depleted the HP of these units. So in this order, these units will die much faster counterpart to these units which not thrown. And this is my mistake. I tried to, you know, punch through a bit. I did some kills, but actually I think I lost more men than I actually kill. It's 110 units and pull offing. The 2 units killed from them. No, but this time I didn't lose anything. Yeah, but I tried something new. I had some tactics. I was trying to, you know, envelop in the battle, charging back my own infantry. It's not the best idea, believe me. And here another javelin trait. Like you can see, my javelin units are just popping out as many javelins as can. I decided to just throw myself into the melee before they are going to throw their old pillar. And like you can see, this unit, I think, didn't have a chance to throw their pillar. So it's good for me. The charge was very successful. I think this unit managed to kill a good amount of the enemy. Yep, 7 kills. A good amount of kills, like I said. Here 8, maybe not the best for javelin units, which I think they've been, you know, depleted with their ammunition pretty well. But like I said, those are Roman units. They have very good armor and big fucking shields, which will help them defending from the enemy projectile that is, you know, throw at them in front. I think we are going to have a small engagement again. He's, you know, pushing his troops more and more here. He's going to envelop from this side where my elephants and infantry is. He hidden his troops somewhere here, I believe. And yeah, his units is already breaking. They took so much casualties from that charge, which is extremely well for me. And because I saw this formation in Prusmoral defense, but lower attack, of course, this is lowering the, you know, the kill rate for them. But also it will tire my unit pretty fast, because they have much, not only slow their kill rate, but of course their own death in the unit, which will be much, much slower, which is of course a good stuff, but much better for defenses, I guess, because you want to punch through this unit pretty fast. Of course, because he have much, much more reinforcements and reserves, he can actually play that long game, because yeah, he can exhaust these units. And if these 3 units are going to be dead, then I have to put another one, you know, and another one, so he can like play the suffer game for me. And like you can see, those units are getting pretty high casualties, but they are fighting against, like, you know, levies that deal very low damage, but they actually tire them up a bit, so my better units can join in and start fighting. I put some phalanx here inside these units. We don't have push through. You know, we agreed on with my friend if we're going to have push through. Push through is like you have a unit of phalanx or anything, you know, that have formation that can punch through the enemy. We're not going to like click, right click, horizontally behind the enemy unit just to get through. Because I feel it's like cheating, first of all. Second of all, it not improve any kind of stuff. And the third thing is just stupid, in my opinion, the game. Because it's not supposed to do work like that. But we don't have anything to say about that. And beautiful charge from my friend. I didn't actually look at it. My phalanxes wasn't in the formation, but I already saw that. And I quickly put them in the formation. My elephants did some damage for them. The charge was pretty good, because the elephants are not the best actually to fight against cavalry, you know, especially they have very many, as many as they have. But I can see a very good view in my phalanxes, that's why I want to have some pikes in the city. They are very, very good. And here the charge, my counter charge to the enemy units, those hoplites are going to be depleted pretty fast. I didn't give them chance to throw the pillar again. They put in the formation again, they've been charged. And I have this beautiful unit of lanciers. They are pretty low, Sarissa lanciers, they have very low calf. But they have extremely good charge bonus, which they can, you know, cycle charge the enemy here. I have to look out for these traps, because I actually can, you know, use them for to my own troops, which will be extremely deadly for me, of course. And yeah, my friend also having, you know, more and more troops here. I don't know what they are doing actually. I think he sent them to check out something. I don't know actually. That's interesting. I have to ask my friend what the fuck is that, because I didn't saw that in battle. I didn't like take you know, good stuff about it, because I was busy here, you know, dealing with that huge Roman army. that are actually two legions. Like you can see, I'm like, you know, enveloping beautifully with my peltast that are also extremely good in melee for an early game unit. I'm trying to circle this unit of Principes so they can break, and my units will just, you know, cycle charge. Like you can see, because of the formation, we have a very similar amount of damage to our units. Of course, my unit is winning slightly, but really, like, on the skin of the teeth, only because this unit is very, very strong in melee. And I mean defense, melee defense and armor, and it's actually increasing that by the formation, which is super OP. And of course, this formation. I mean, only bad thing about this formation that we won't have is the accessibility, because you cannot get wide enough with this unit, and it will be really helpful. I mean, it's really helpful for me, so I can envelop them faster, because they don't have like widespread units. Like in Phalanx, you can spread them in like one line. I mean, maybe not like one, but like five ranks, and they are very good in much wider formation, which will help you to defend the city. And like I said, this unit broke because I, you know, enveloped them with my peltasts that are actually getting some good amount of kills. And again, this is about breaking, enemy units and not getting them any kind of return to the battle, because then it's going to be very, very bad. Like you can see, I sent it some light infantry that are basically javelins. Of course, just to support this front, because it's going to, you know, get more and more troops. Even light infantry is good to, you know, support back of these troops. They'll have higher morale and you know, much better stance against this stuff, because yeah, he put good amount of troops, like 4 units of infantry and 4 units of cavalry, so it's really good for him. I'm charging my back, I know, but it was to kill off enemy units. So like you see, white flag, because of the new update of the AI, if the enemy unit is going to break, or even your own unit is going to break, like here for example, they're going to return eventually. And it's really, really bad for you, because if they're going to return, that's mean the balance of power is going to the enemy favor, because they actually can use this troop again, so you actually have to deal with them. Of course, they're going to be much, much weaker, because they'll be broke, they will be tired or winded, like here. Their strength there will be going down. They are like performance will be much, much lower. And here he's going to, you know, like stay here in these traps, because I cannot charge him with my elephants. So I decide put one more units here, help some units here, you know, regroup them a bit, because I don't want to envelop them as much as I did here. Another charge, maybe not the best. And I think I forgot about them, so I put them in the melee for much, much longer than I was supposed to, which is very bad against Spear Manipul, which is Princeps here. Beautiful charge from my elephants, they're racking kills. They damaging morale of the enemy units. They are very formation breach, yeah. And my infantry charge, my elephant charge, I deal some damage, pull out. Yeah, that was my whole strategy here. I knew in long-term battle, they're going to slaughter me here, because they have much, much heavier troops than I have. I didn't recruit any hoplites in this army, so it is actually really bad for me. I decided to put 2 units of pikemen here, because I was really, really scared about, you know, enemy getting through here, and I knew if he's going to send more troops here, I can easily deal with them with my just charging my elephants and, you know, breaking these units again and again. Especially he's not, I mean, he actually could destroy these traps using his units, but actually I think he's forgot about that. But anyway, like I said, those units are going to return, and they, yeah, maybe they didn't kill many, but actually they are a threat. They have to deal with them again, and they are not very bad unit. You know, they are Italic mercenary swords. The swords actually have good amount of, you know, melee defense and decent armor. You know, the unit is a unit, right? You can use them eventually to tire me up or even, you know, destroy some of my units. Yeah, so this charge is going to be again like 40 more kills on those elephants. And again, I should like pull them back right over. I charge them. I forget about my infantry. I was like micro charging here. Look at this. My cavalry was, you know, punching through. My infantry was trying to destroy these triarii because this is very dangerous units to play against. Like you can see, they are basically slaughtering those peltasts, and actually didn't have any good thing to counter them. My cavalry just breaking because they didn't have enough men. Because this unit was fighting here for too long. You can see casualties I get from that. Another thing, because I'm in the city, which is good and bad, of course, like everything in the world, I guess. When my unit is going to retreat, they are going to retreat to one of these corridors, one of these choke points. And because he have troops in this every single choke point, my unit, that when they are going to retreat, they're going to die. So every single unit in my army, when they break, their morale are going to broke, they are dead for all. Like, you know, they're not going to survive. Like the small portion, like this, for example, unit can, like, you know, pull. These spears just pull out. They actually can return later because they didn't broke like 100%. They are like white flag here, so actually they can return to the battlefield. But like you can see, my casualties are growing in numbers. I put my phalanx. I throw my, you know, melee infantry here to deal some damage. But it's really, really tough fighting here because the Rome have also very elite army. I mean, look at this. The balance of power, it's extremely, extremely against my favor, right? I have really few units. I didn't have like plan to defeat them all. I was like hoping to hold up enough time. Maybe on Skin of the Thief I'll be able to just win that. Just you know, putting my soldiers. Be this is why I didn't like build my forces right away here, you know, because then I would be trapped and slaughtered. My elephants and calf wouldn't do anything, and probably my own calf would be shot down very quickly by the enemy slingers. And like you can see, this is very close fighting. Like my units is going to break soon. Yeah, they're going to break. They're like, fuck this shit, I'm exhausted, no more for me, bro, I'm going to run away. And this is when I was like, shit, my other units is going to break. And yeah, this is the charge that just destroyed my whole line here. I was like pretty scared that I'm going to lose this battle, but I was like, shit. Okay, this front is steady. It's good enough to hold up for a few more minutes, I think. I suppose maybe they're very tired, but they have like three. This is three units of you know, spearsmen and swordsmen, so they are very good in very tight formation. I have one free unit that I can actually use to, you know, send some reinforcements. So I throw my own elephants to this fray of battle to deal some damage to disrupt the enemy line. Here again, I was trying to like slow down any kind of, you know, enemy engagements. They send it calf. They didn't put any regards of their lives. They just charged through the spikes and died a lot, like you can see. Yeah, this unit is not very good against in cavalry. That was my mistake in build army. When I was recruiting soldiers, I didn't bring enough spearmen. I didn't like. I should have much more infantry and better cavalry units. But it was like turn like 3 or 4. So I have like few turns in the early game to just throw my army away into the Rome territory, capture as many cities as I can before they are regrouped from the Etruscan Wars to finish them off, charge me with the full potential of the legions, and I have only hope to defend myself and maybe win the battle or slow their offensive down so I can, you know, build more forces in the reserves in Taras. As you can see here, my units are holding pretty well. I did lost elephants though, unfortunately, but yeah, this was very vicious fighting. He's throwing like his light troops to again exhaust my units. You can see I did kill many enemy legionaries. Many Romans here are laying dead, but it's not enough. They have more and more, like you can see, like two units they're coming here to just kill me, and those are princes. They are principes and they are very good at killing. They are fresh. They want to fight, they throw the pillar, and they are fighting it basically light and medium infantry. So yeah, it's not very good for me. I was like, I have to pull off. I have to do something to, you know, win this battle for time, or, you know, for exhaustion. Maybe my units will be able to kill them off. Because actually, like you can see here, many of the Roman army are going to, you know, grind down themselves in the streets. Like for example here, like they are pushing with fresh and fresh units more and more, just to be here, just to punch the hole, or just to, you know, threat my line behind so they can, you know, swarm me from every single direction. I was like, yeah, I'm in very big issue here. I have like very big no-no, because this is going to break eventually, unfortunately. Yeah, because this amount of infantry I'll not able to hold, especially if they are all tired. I mean, maybe not my main unit here of my elite infantry, maybe not them, but actually yeah, I want to preserve them for much longer than just, you know, die here. And especially if this flank is going to collapse, they're going to die. So I sacrificed my pelters, my javelin men, to throw themselves so they can hold up as long as possible against this. I was like, I was super scared they are going to charge with their cav and punch through and, you know, catch my units there when they're retreating here. But I actually was successful with that maneuver. I was like, well, I have to sacrifice some units here, unfortunately. I was like, yeah, either I'm going to put them here and, you know, but these units were tired and they will be not able to run in time here, because this unit is going to grind down themselves pretty soon. They are not able to hold out for longer, especially that kind of, you know, they are fighting against three other units, you know. Maybe they are exhausted, but they are still Romans. They very have very good stamina. And yeah, a little big breakthrough for me. I was like, yeah, but retreat maybe, it's not a good idea. I broke this unit, so I was like, yep, go back. And the order issue just came in. And I was like, yeah, I'll not able to hold out, but I have to put this infantry here in this corridor, because if they get through, I'm dead. Yeah, my cavalry just broke. My infantry here actually holding up pretty decent, but unfortunately my own infantry here that I sent it for sacrificial intelligence to, you know, pull back my units, did collapse eventually. So I have like two units of swordsmen left inside, three units of pikesmen, which one is extremely vital and not even very tired. Here another unit of pikemen that are extremely tired, and they're very low in numbers. They like majority of the units is dead, and yeah, they have more and more reserves, right? You can see they have like two more units of reserve, sorry, three more units in reserves here, including a general that is going to, you know, increase morale of this unit so it will not break easily. I'm trying to do myself same thing, but yeah, they break here. My lone unit are just like, yeah, we're going to last stand here. This is no way we are able to run in time here. Unfortunately, they didn't have time. I wouldn't risk them, you know, putting them in danger so they can, you know, kill someone, maybe deal some damage. So they are fighting to the last. They are fighting against fresh units of Principes. And you look at this balance of power, you know, I have like 4 minutes left, and then I was pretty confident I am able to win that. But then more and more units of mine are going to, they started to breaking. Basically, like, you know, for example, those phalangites, those pikes are exhausted. They are losing melee decisively because of exhaustion, right? Those units are exhausted too. They are very tired, and they just basically moving much fresher units than I have. You can see they are basically, my enemy is wisely putting units in the charge because he's switching them off for fresh, and the tired one are going to the back, get a bit of, you know, brief moment for them, and they are back in the battle switching off their teammates to deal more and more damage. I don't have this luxury because I did basically didn't have enough amount of reserves at this point. I only have this unit and these brave soldiers that tried to put the last stand, but actually they've been slaughtered, unfortunately, because of lack of morale. Not only lack of morale, probably because also of the charge from the cavalry. Oh, sorry. Charge from the cavalrymen, because they're actually, you know, very vulnerable for that. So yeah, he have more and more troops here. He basically can pass through. But very, very fortunately for me, I have this like very vital pike unit that can hold here for a pretty long time. They are inspired also, so they have higher morale. Yeah, the forces outnumbered by the enemy, that's true. And because of that, more and more of my units are going to break. But I send in my fresh units of infantry, which didn't seem battle much in these days. So they are like last stand unit to play against. And I was like, yeah, I have to do something. My general is staying here in the back, increasing morale. He's like, go guys, kill them all. And time to time is trying to charge. Very awful charge. I mean, I did try just, you know, some disrupt enemy lines maybe a bit. Sometimes it's helpful, but in this particular scenario it didn't help me at all. I actually disrupted my own line so the enemy can charge through these breaks and, you know, break my morale. And like you can see, the spears, more and more units is going to break for me. And I have like one unit of spears here are, you know, running back. They are trying to, you know, outflank the enemy. But yeah, those guys don't have any kind of, you know, they just casualty sustained. They are not able to hold long enough to deal any kind of damage or even slow the advance because Luke, he's sending more and more troops here because he saw he's like out of reserves and he's, you know, trying to punch through the holes. I was like, there's like 1 minute left in the battle. This phalanx is staying steady. And yeah, they are holding, they are doing their job pretty great at this decision to, you know, come back to this last city point was basically last hope to win this battle in time. But I was extremely careful with my general. I was so worried about my king will die here in the battle. Because if I'm going to lose this battle in the city, of course he's not able to escape the battle, so he's going to die and buried with his men, which will be actually the end of campaign actually for me. I have to rebuild in Taras and, you know, eventually try to something else. But this is very lucky charge for me. I was able to scare them off, break their morale, because I outflanked them a bit here with this charge, and like you can see they basically start breaking. But he saw that, he threw his own units, but because he disrupted his own line, his units start to fall in their disorder. And it was like extremely close combat. It was like Jesus Christ, like sending all you got, because He'll try to punch through this unit. This infantry of Epirus, it's not the best one to hold against cavalry. And like that, the enemy was out of time. So it was pretty close battle. I mean, I was so worried I'm going to lose that. Actually, my reinforcements didn't arrive. I have like another 10 units in reserves next to the city, but actually they have like few meters, just, you know, like millimeters to get next to the city, so they could be in reinforcement range, but nope, fuck me here. I have to like deal with that I had. So I have very big disadvantage in numbers. I sustain very high casualties. Unfortunately, we don't have any more units for Rome, only the general that didn't sustain any big amount of casualties in his units. He killed 42. I didn't put my king in danger, but he was able to kill some. Of course, this unit was starting with this number because I took over the city in previous turn. So majority of my soldiers were a bit lower in numbers in the first stage of the battle. Like you can see, I have 3,600 men. My enemy have 5,000 men. So yeah, and of course, majority of them was heavy infantry. So I have like six Thesprian infantry, three spears, three javelins. I think three additional cavalrymen, not counting the general, and three phalangites. Phalangites and the one elephant that actually survived the battle and serving me well. And yeah, they are very strong unit to have them on the battlefield against Rome. They actually have experience a bit, and because of that I actually was able to put the enemy down on the spot. But unfortunately, I would love to show you, like, maybe if anybody was able to, you know, watch this movie, watch this video into the end, I can only tell you that I have to actually retreat from Beneventum. And the Rome retake it. But I was very lucky because he put it in my ambush, little trick ambush, where I was able to defeat the two full legions of Rome with actually low casualties. But I mean, low casualties, I lost like one full army that was actually in the city. And Rome did also lost full army, and they are rebuilding also. So it's like the stage of the war when the both sides, like, you know, exhausted their forces. The battles were indecisive because the both sides did lost many troops. And that's why I love basically head-to-head campaigns, because the AI is so stupid and boring in a long-term relationship with Total Wars. And when you're playing against your friend that know your moves and can adapt to the situation with the army and tactics and strategy, overall it's so much interesting, you know, because he can, you know, put some traps, do something creative with his army, deal much more damage, you know, like your plan was going to campaign against, for example, Syria. But for some reason, the AI themselves that are going to attack, invade the Syria before you do, and you have to fight them also. And the battles, you have to do manually because they have like advantage of, you know, terms of, for example, the number of troops. And this is extremely, extremely interesting. I really encourage every single Total player to play against your friends, not in like cooperative mode, because it's actually boring. Maybe if you're playing against like super difficult AI, like on legendary mode, but then it's like pure masochism, because in my opinion, the AI having boost in every single digital way for, you know, troops, morale, the weapon damage, income, and it's just brutal fighting. We don't have any sense, and immersion is just, you know, like thermopile every single time you're playing the battle, you know, like the brave 300 of your men holding against the hordes of the AI, a legendary difficulty. So it's just boring. And yeah, head to head, I really appreciate my friend here for playing the battle. I have few more, of course, in this campaign. I hope it will be much longer campaign than last one. Yeah, and yeah, see you later. I hope that you have fun.